Om Shri Sai Ram. Shri Sai Satcharita, written by Hemadpantji and translated by Gunaji. Chapter 28. Sai is not finite or limited. He dwells in all beings, from ants and insects to the god Brahma. He pervades all. Sai was well versed in the knowledge of the Vedas as well as in the science of self-realization. As he was proficient in both these, he was well fitted to be the Sadguru. Anyone, though learned but not able to awaken the disciples and establish them in self-realization, does not deserve to be called a Sadguru. Generally, the father gives birth to the body and death invariably follows life. But Sadguru does away with both life and death, and so he is more kind and merciful than anybody. Sai Baba often said that let his man, or that is devotee, be at any distance, 1,000 kos away from him, he will be drawn to Shirdi like a sparrow with a thread tied to its feet. This chapter describes the stories of three such sparrows. Lala Lakshmi Chand. This gentleman was first serving in the railways and afterwards in Sri Venkateshwar Press in Bombay, and thereafter in the firm of Messrs. Raleigh Brothers as a munshi or clerk. He got the contact of Baba in 1910. 1 or 2 months before Christmas, he saw in his dream at Santa Cruz, a suburb of Bombay, an old man with a beard standing and surrounded by his bhaktas. Some days later, he went to the house of his friend, Mr. Dattatreya Manjunath Bijur, to hear the Kirtan by Dasganu. It was always the practice of Dasganu to keep Baba's picture in front of the audience while making the Kirtan. Lakshmi Chand was surprised to see that the features of the old man he saw in his dream tallied exactly with those in the picture, and thus he came to the conclusion that the old man he saw in his dream was Sai Baba himself. The sight of the picture, Dasganu's Kirtan, and the life of the Saint Tukaram, on which Dasganu discoursed, all these things made a deep impression on his mind, and he pined to go to Shirdi. It is always the experience of the bhaktas that God always helps them in their search for Sadguru and other spiritual endeavors. That very night at 8 p.m., a friend named Shankar Rao knocked at his door and asked him whether he would accompany him to Shirdi. His joy knew no bounds, and he at once decided to go to Shirdi. He borrowed 15 rupees from his cousin and, after making due preparations, left for Shirdi. In the train, he and his friend Shankar Rao did some bhajan or sang religious songs and inquired about Sai Baba with some fellow passengers, four Mohammedans who were returning to their place near Shirdi. They all told that Sai Baba was a great saint living in Shirdi for many years. Then when they reached Kopalgaon, he wanted to buy some good guavas for offering to Baba. But he was so much enwrapped with the scenery and sights there that he forgot to purchase them. When they were nearing Shirdi, he was reminded of the guavas. Just then, he saw an old woman with a guava basket on her head running after the tonga. The tonga was stopped and he gladly purchased some select fruits when the woman said, "Take all the rest and offer them on my behalf to Baba." The fact that he had intended to purchase guavas, but that he had forgotten to do so. The old woman's encounter and her devotion to Baba, all these were a surprise to both friends. And Lakshmi Chand thought in his mind that the old woman might be some relation of the old man he saw in his dream. Then they drove on and came near Shirdi, and on seeing flags on the masjid, they saluted them. With puja materials in hand, they then went to the masjid and worshipped Baba with due formality. Lakshmi Chand was much moved and was extremely happy to see Baba. He was enwrapped with Baba's feet as a bee with a sweet-smelling lotus. Then Baba spoke as follows, "Cunning fellow, he does bhajan on the way and inquires from others. Why ask others? Everything we should see with our own eyes. Where is the necessity to question others? Just think for yourself whether your dream is true or not. Where was the necessity of the darshan by taking a loan from a Marwari? Is the heart's desire now satisfied?" Hearing these words, Lakshmi Chand was wonderstruck at Baba's omniscience. He was at a loss to know how Baba came to know about all the things that had happened en route from his house to Shirdi. The chief thing to note in this respect is that Baba never liked people to run into debt for taking his darshan or celebrating any holiday or making any pilgrimage. Sanja. At noon, when Lakshmi Chand was sitting for meals, he got some sanja, that is wheat pudding, from a devotee as prasad. He was pleased to have it. Next day also, he expected it but got nothing. So he was anxious to get it again. Then on the third day at the noon aarti time, Bapu Sahib Jog asked Baba what navedya he should bring. Baba told him to bring sanja. Then the bhaktas brought two big potfuls of sanja. Lakshmi Chand was very hungry and there was some pain in his back. Then Baba said to him, "It is good that you are hungry. Take sanja and some medicine for the pain in the back." He was again wonderstruck to see that Baba again read his mind and spoke out what was passing therein. How omniscient was he! Evil eye. On this occasion, he once witnessed one night the procession to the chavadi. Baba then suffered much from cough. He thought that the suffering of Baba might be due to somebody's evil eye. Next morning, when he went to the masjid, Baba spoke to Shama as follows, "I suffered last night from cough. Is it due to some evil eye? I think that somebody's evil eye has worked on me and I'm suffering." In this case, Baba spoke out what was passing in Lakshmi Chand's mind. On seeing these proofs of Baba's omniscience and kindness to his bhaktas, he fell prostrate at Baba's feet and said, "I'm much pleased with your darshan." ever be kind and merciful to me and protect me always. There is no other God to me in this world except your feet. Let my mind be ever wrapped in your bhajan and feet. Let your grace protect me from the miseries of the world and let me ever chant your name and be happy. After getting Baba Udi and blessing, he returned home with his friend, much pleased and contented, and singing Baba's glory on the way. He remained a staunch devotee of Baba afterwards and always sent garlands of flowers, camphor and dakshina with any person of his acquaintance bound for Shirdi. Buranpur Lady. Now let us turn to another sparrow, Baba's word meaning devotee. One lady in Buranpur saw in her dream Sai Baba coming to her door and begging khichdi, that is rice cooked with dal and salt, for his meals. On awakening, she saw nobody at her door. However, she was pleased with the vision and told it to all, including her husband. He was employed in the postal department, and when he was transferred to Akola, both husband and wife, who were devout, decided to go to Shirdi. Then on a suitable day, they left for Shirdi, and after visiting Gomati Teeth on the way, reached Shirdi and stayed there for 2 months. Every day they went to the masjid, performed Baba's worship and passed their time happily. The couple came to Shirdi to offer khichdi as naivedya, but for the first 14 days, somehow or other, it could not be offered. The lady did not like this delay. Then on the 15th day, she came at noon to the masjid with her khichdi. There she found that Baba and others were already sitting for meals and that the curtain was down. Nobody did anything.